Hi everyone, welcome back to the Daily Signal and to another episode of System Fracture, where we dissect the cyber threats that define our digital reality. Today, we are diving into the CVE-2025-13223, one of the most dangerous Chrome Zero Days we have seen this year. A vulnerability so trivial to trigger, it requires, well, nothing from you. Just opening a browser tab. This was actively exploited in the wild before Google even had a patch ready. And the scary part is that millions of people were likely using the vulnerable build without knowing it. By the end of this video, you will understand how this flaw works, why it's so valuable to threat actors, and how attackers chain it with sandbox escape vulnerabilities to get full system compromise. All right, so let's break it down. So first, what exactly is CVE-2025-13223? This is a type confusion flaw inside Chrome's V8 JavaScript engine. Essentially the part of Chrome responsible for running every piece of JavaScript on every website you visit. The impact is massive. A crafted web page can trigger heap corruption and execute code inside the Chrome renderer. That means the attacker can run code inside your browser with no downloads, no confirmation, no pop-ups. This flaw was discovered on November 12th by Clement Lessing of Google's threat analysis group. And whenever tag is involved, the threat analysis group, it usually means we are looking at something used in high-end targeted operations. This zero day stays inside the Chrome sandbox at first, but it's the perfect first stage of a multi-stage attack chain. To understand why type confusion is dangerous, let me simplify it for you. V8 relies heavily on assumptions to optimize code. If it thinks an array contains only integers, it optimizes aggressively on that assumption. But if an attacker can trick V8 into believing one type is present when another type is actually stored in memory, V8 starts reading the wrong fields, writing into the wrong regions, and suddenly the attacker gains the holy grail of browser exploitation: arbitrary read and write inside the renderer process. This is how heap metadata gets corrupted. It's how an attacker can forge objects, rewrite pointers, and ultimately execute their own code inside the renderer. And once you have arbitrary code execution inside the renderer, you are basically one step away from escaping the sandbox altogether. Here's the phase one chain attackers use. Step one, deliver a malicious link. Phishing email, WhatsApp message, malicious ad, compromised website, you name it. Step two, serve a page containing highly optimized JavaScript that first warms up V8, then flips the type assumptions. Step three, force the type confusion, corrupt the heap, obtain arbitrary read-write. Fourth, pivot to renderer-level code execution. At this stage, the attacker controls your browser, but still inside the sandbox. And that's where the next slide comes in. So, how do attackers escape Chrome's sandbox once they have gained renderer-level execution? In 2025, so far, two major sandbox escape vulnerabilities were available, both used in real-world exploitation. The 2025-27-83 Mojo sandbox escape, a flaw in Chrome's Mojo IPC subsystem, allowing malicious messages from the renderer to cause privileged operations in the browser process. And the second one, the 2025-6558, ANGLE GPU sandbox escape, a flaw in the GPU ANGLE pipeline where untrusted data wasn't validated correctly, enabling attackers to break out via the GPU process. These are post-exploitation escalation bugs. The CVE-2025-13223 gives attacker initial execution, and these two give them the keys to the kingdom. It's a classic chain renderer, GPU or browser system. Now let's go deeper into how one of these actually works under the hood. Mojo is Chrome's high-performance messaging system. It's how the renderer and the browser talk to each other without exposing direct system calls. But if you gain execution inside the renderer, you can craft malformed Mojo messages. Here's the key issue. The Mojo channel shares a kernel-owned object called a message pipe. When the renderer sends a message, Mojo is supposed to validate the handles and object state before passing anything to the browser process. But in this CVE, the 2025-2783, that validation is flawed. Attackers can perform something known as handle poisoning, injecting a manipulated handle into a Mojo message, which desynchronizes the browser's internal state machine. Once the attacker corrupts the browser process's interpretation of a handle, they can trigger privileged operations that were never intended to be accessible from the renderer. That's the escape. It's subtle, elegant, and extremely effective in the hands of well-funded actors. Now let's zoom out. Chrome runs on more than 2 billion devices. That means a Chrome Zero-Day is not just a bug, it's infrastructure leverage. Commercial spyware vendors want it, nation-state APTs want it, cybercriminal crews want it, though they often wait until after a patch drops. Browser Zero-Days are strategic assets. They bypass traditional defenses, they target high-value individuals, they cross air gaps through social engineering, and they blend perfectly into everyday browsing behavior. In the modern threat landscape, a browser exploit chain is the digital equivalent of a precision-guided missile. And this CVE, the CVE-2025-13223, fits that mold perfectly. Here's what matters for you right now. If you're a regular user, update Chrome or any Chromium-based browser to the latest version. Enable automatic updates and restart your browser regularly. Be careful with unsolicited links or shortened URLs, especially during periods when new zero days are actively exploited. If you are a defender, on the other hand, inventory all Chrome and Chromium builds in your environment and find everything below version 1.4.2. Hunt for suspicious chains, renderer crashes followed by GPU or Mojo anomalies. In your threat intel mapping, track 13.2.2.3 together with 27.8.3 and 65.5.8. Assume chaining. Shift your mindset. Browser zero days are not just patching items anymore. Treat them as potential lateral movement enablers. This bug is just a reminder. Your browser is now one of the most targeted entry points into your entire digital ecosystem. CVE-2025-13223 is a perfect example of how fragile our digital systems can be. A tiny assumption in a massive code base, a subtle optimization error, and suddenly, one malicious tab can become a full system compromise. The real danger is not just a bug. It's how attackers chain these bugs together. If you found this breakdown valuable, make sure you like, subscribe, and check out the full playlist for System Fracture here on the Daily Signal. We dive into the vulnerabilities shaping geopolitics, cybercrime, and the future of digital security. Thank you for watching. I'm Max, Point Break Security, and stay sharp out there.